Good afternoon. An abusive passenger could be charged after a terrifying mid-air ordeal on a Qantas flight from Bali to Melbourne. Adam Hegarty has the details.
Well, the 28-year-old man detained in this mid-air drama was taken straight to hospital from Melbourne Airport. He's facing the prospect of being banned from the national carrier, and he's also facing possible charges from federal police. This vision you're seeing here was filmed by several passengers aboard a QF46 from Denpasar to Melbourne overnight. You can see there it took around 5 passengers to bring the man to the ground and detain him for much of the flight. That was after a series of unhinged outbursts. Passengers have also told Nine News the ordeal began when the man threatened a flight attendant lunging at her before other Qantas crew were forced to step in. It began about an hour into the flight, the moment lights went out. Then over the course of around 4 hours, flight attendants were forced to take turns keeping the man on the ground in the middle of the aisle, his hands tied behind his back and his head placed face down on a pillow. Quite the terrifying experience.
He started screaming and everybody was panicking. It was pretty scary. He attacked like 2 or 3 of the passengers.
Thankfully, Qantas and the AFP have confirmed no one was injured on board.
Australians are preparing to farewell 2023 in style, with millions flocking to celebrations to ring in the new year. We have reporters live right across the country. First to Annalise Bolt in Sydney, where there was a mad scramble to reserve the best spots. Annalise, how are people preparing for a very big night?
There has been a mad scramble, but I think I found the best spot to watch the Sydney fireworks. We'll give you a bit of a look around. This is Farm Cove, and some of the boats have been anchored here for days, and you can see why. It's smack bang in front of the Opera House and the Harbour Bridge. There's right now around 1,500 boats on the harbour. Normally that reaches around 3,000 by midnight, so it does seem that the wet weather is keeping some of those boaties at bay, but those on the water are making the most of it. Some have travelled down from Queensland, others have come from as far as England as well as Hawaii, but the really big crowds that we've been seeing are on land. Most of the popular vantage points are actually now full, and we are expecting a crowd of around 1 million people to pack into the harbour, which is one of the biggest that we've seen in a long time. You can see people are getting pretty creative with their boats out here. Anything that floats is fair game. Now we're just waiting until the fireworks in just a few hours.
That is an impressive setup. Thank you, Annalise. Okay, now to Reid Butler in Melbourne, where the CBD is the place to be in to ring in the new year. Reid, preparations are in full swing.
Yeah, Steph, and it's been a while since we've seen any kind of sunshine in Melbourne, so thankfully she's come out just in time. And what better place to celebrate than where I am, at a bar or a boat there as well. That looks pretty good. This is a bar floating on the Yarra, actually. It's called A Float, and about 900 people will pack this bar tonight to watch the fireworks, and it's a pretty epic spot to do that. But I think the party, as you can probably hear, has actually already started across the city. It is good vibes only. At the peak, more than 400,000 people are expected here in the CBD. There are plenty of fantastic places where you can watch, free areas too, from Docklands to Flagstaff Gardens with DJs and food trucks and that sort of thing. But as our Lord Mayor said today, Steph, if you can see the skyline, whether you're in Frankston or Ferntree Gully, you're going to be able to see those fireworks this evening. It is that time of year where we all think about how we're going to improve things, what is 2024 going to look like. I thought I'd take it upon myself to ask people enjoying the city today what their New Year's resolutions were. Do you have any New Year's resolutions?
Get fit.
Eat well, drink well.
Going on some new holidays.
Good.
Saving money.
Happy New Year!
Steph, I don't know how saving money and going on more holidays is going to work, but I'll leave it up to that household to work that out.
They've got some negotiating ahead. Thank you, Reid. And Claire Todhunter is in Brisbane this evening. Claire, revelers there are securing their spots early this year too.
Yeah, they are, Stephanie. Around 100,000 people are expected to be out celebrating New Year's Eve across Brisbane tonight. You might even be able to see behind me a number of boats have already secured their prime positions on the river ahead of all the light shows we've got going on around town today. But we have also seen a lot of people setting up their vantage points alongside the river. One man getting there at 6 o'clock this morning to make sure he had that best spot, which you have to admire that dedication, given we are out in the hot Queensland sun today. We've had tops of 31 degrees, so certainly very hot, but they have come prepared. Lots of water and making sure they've got shade down there as well. Now, the first light show tonight kicks off at 7:45 at Howard Smith Wharves before the two main shows in Brisbane at 8:30 p.m. and again at midnight, of course.
Thank you so much, Claire. Looks like a good night ahead right across the board. Well, disposable vapes will be banned at the border from tomorrow as the federal government moves to tackle nicotine addiction. Federal politics reporter Eliza Edwards has the details.
It's become increasingly clear the harm vapes are causing in our communities and in our schools, described as Australia's biggest public health menace, with one in five 18 to 25-year-olds already hooked. Now the government is trying to turn off the supply tap for disposable vapes. From tomorrow, the importation of the products will be illegal, meaning any found at the border will be destroyed, and there'll be fines for those caught trying to bring them into the country. But for the vapes already in Australia, it's going to be a tough task to get rid of them.
We know how easy it has been for young people to get their hands on vapes through many different, whether they be retail or non-retail options, you know, through friends and, you know, an underground market. That's what's got to get stamped out starting from tomorrow as well.
The only cohort where smoking rates are actually climbing now is our youngest members of the community, and we're determined to reverse that.
Early in the new year, the federal government is also planning to outlaw the supply and domestic manufacture of vapes, with big penalties expected for sellers.
A mother of two has been killed in a shocking crash in Adelaide. As Kelly Hughes reports, her husband has been arrested.
Emergency services rushed to the eastern suburbs road here after reports that a woman had been hit by a car.
A team of paramedics worked tirelessly at the scene to try to save her just after 8 last night, while major crash investigators inspected a Volkswagen ute nearby.
The street was cordoned off. There were a few of the ambulances. I think there was a fire truck and a few of the police cars. They were blocking off the road.
It's very sad. It's a terrible thing to happen.
The 32-year-old was rushed to hospital but died from her injuries overnight. Neighbours say the young family had only recently moved onto the street.
It's awful. We wouldn't like it to happen to anyone.
It's quite tragic, and we feel sorry for what has happened. We've never seen such a sight on this street. It was quite horrific to see.
The woman's husband was arrested and charged with causing death by dangerous driving, driving without due care and endangering life.
The 33-year-old man was given bail and is said to face court next year.
A teenager is fighting for life in hospital after being stabbed during a street fight between two groups in Brisbane's West overnight. Olivana Lathouris reports.
Police detectives are combing through this quiet suburban street after it became the scene of a violent brawl last night. Neighbours have told Nine News they heard screaming and screeching tyres just after 11 p.m. when the fight broke out on Calander Street, some describing a group of more than a dozen people gathered in the middle of the road as the fight escalated. Concerned residents called police, who arrived to find a 14-year-old boy suffering a serious stab wound to the stomach.
I just can't comprehend that it's actually happened, because it's just so quiet around here and we don't get that sort of trouble.
And then people were just screaming. I think people got hurt.
Several police units, including a dog squad and police helicopter, were called in to secure the scene. The teenager taken to hospital, where he remains in a critical but stable condition. Today, investigators spent the morning door-knocking residents in an attempt to piece together exactly what unfolded. It's understood the fight involved two groups known to each other, with five people taken into custody.
We've identified the main players involved in this. We don't believe that there's any ongoing public safety concern.
Authorities are calling on anyone who may have video footage of the incident to come forward.